Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel Life Science with KMD. Today I'm going to explain about lambda phage DNA as a vector. Lambda phage was first discovered at Pasteur Institute by Andre when he observed the strain E. coli. He showed that the cells of these bacterial strains carried bacteriophage is in a dormant form, that is prophage stage. Now phage can alter between lysogenic, that is non-productive, and lytic, which is a productive growth cycle. Lambda phage is a double-stranded DNA molecule. It consists of a 12 base pair, which is at the 5 prime. It consists of a 12 base pair sticky end at the 5 prime end, called as cos site. It is used for cloning vector accommodating fragment of DNA up to 15 kb base pair long. For large piece, the cosmid or YAC are used, while will accept foreign DNA and still complete their life cycle. Distinguish cells that have foreign and non-foreign DNA should replicate in host. Gene of interest can be identified and grown in large amount. Non-essential gene can be removed and replaced by foreign gene. If we use lambda phage as a vector, it should carry one or more selectable marker that identify the parent and recombinant vector. Should have a restriction site in non-essential region of the DNA into which the foreign DNA can be inserted. Easy to make and maintain library. Enzymes needed are restriction enzyme. Cut the DNA at specific sequence to generate a set of fragment and a DNA ligase. To insert DNA restriction fragment into the replicating DNA molecule to produce recombinant DNA. So DNA ligase is required. So that insert a DNA restriction fragment into replicating DNA molecule to produce a recombinant DNA. Lambda vector itself are of two type. One is insertion vector, where it consists of one restriction site. Another one, restriction site where you can insert the DNA of our interest. Whereas another one is the replacement vector, where it consists of a two restriction site and you can replace the lambda DNA part from this site to this site and insert the gene of our interest here. Here we are not going to replace any DNA fragment of the lambda vector, I mean lambda phage. Whereas here we replace the part of the DNA fragment of lambda phage with that of our gene of interest. Here just the DNA will be inserted directly without any replacement. So there are two types, one is insertion vector and a replacement vector. Now central one third is the stuffer fragment. Segment of the lambda DNA are removed and stuffer fragment is put in. This keeps the vector in a correct size. Usually using restriction enzyme and a ligase enzyme, gene of our interest will be added at the stuffer fragment and we will remove the stuffer fragment and replace this stuffer fragment with that of our gene of our interest. Gene to be cloned can be introduced into the cloning vector and at one of the restriction site. And this, if you see this as a vector, then this one is the multiple cloning site. So here gene of our interest can be inserted here, one of the restriction site present on the cloning site. Maturation of phage lambda passes through several stages. The empty head change shape and expand when it becomes filled with DNA. The electron micrograph shows the particle at the start and at the end of the maturation pathway. Steps of cloning. isolated vector DNA and isolate the vector DNA and gene of our interest, cut both with restriction enzyme ECOR1, and then connect two fragment of foreign DNA with the DNA ligase so that we can get a recombinant DNA. Package the DNA by adding cell extract containing head and tail protein. Transfer recombinant molecule into the host cell. Grow or select the transformant. Check recombinant phage for presence of desirable foreign DNA sequence by observing it by observing its genetic properties. Coming to the life cycle of lambda phage is that the lambda phage genome consists of contain 50,000 nucleotide pairs and encode about 50 protein. It's double stranded DNA protein. It consists of a double stranded DNA exist in either linear or a circular form. Bacteriophage can multiply either in a lytic or a lysogenic pathway in E. coli, that is E. coli bacterium. When the bacteriophage is growing in lysogenic state, damage to the cell causes the integrated viral DNA, that is the provirus, to exit from the host chromosome and shift to a lytic growth. The entrance and exit of the DNA from the chromosome are site-specific genetic recombination event catalyzed by lambda integrase protein. Now PL, the promoter for transcript for the left side of lambda and left side of the lambda with N and C3. Now this PL is the promoter for transcription for left side of the lambda with N and C3. Now whereas PR is the promoter for right side, and it include CRO and C2 and the gene encoding the structural protein. Now this OL and OR is a short non-coding region of the genome. They control the promoter. CL is the repressor protein of 236 amino acid, which binds to the OR and OL, preventing transcription of CRO and N, but allowing the transcription of OL and other genes in the left-handed end. CL2 and CL3 encode activator protein, which binds to the genome. CRO, which is a 66 amino acid protein, which binds to OR and OL, blocking the binding of the receptor to this site to prevent lysogeny. Encodes an anti-terminator protein and allow transcription from PL and PR. It also allow RNA polymerase to transcribe a number of phage genes, including those responsible for recombination and integration of the phage, as well as CL2 and C2 and C3. Next is the Q. Q is an anti-terminator similar to AN, but only permits extended transcription of PR. Two terminator site, one between N and C3 and other between COR and C2. Immediate early gene expression or seen in case of N gene and CRO gene. Delay early gene expression was seen in case of C3 and C2, and even Q will be expressed in the later stages. Now, in case of lysogeny, the transcription of PL and PR is blocked, whereas in case of lytic infection, PL and PR are both active. Life cycle of lambda. Virus enter the cell, PL and PR get activated. PL transcribe to make N protein, PR transcribe to make crow protein. Termination site stop transcription, but when enough N protein is made, transcription goes past these two stop sites. You can now make CL3 and C3 and C2. Replication protein like O and P and Q are produced. There is also a termination site next to the Q protein, which is next to the Q protein, will allow the transcription past this site. The CRO protein blocks the production of C1, goes to lytic. If C2 and C3 activates transcription to make C1, goes lysogenic. CL blocks PL and PR, stop transcription to bind the OL and OR. Now, how does the cell lysogeny now how does the cell leaves the lysogeny cycle and goes to lytic cycle? By stress, ultraviolet radiation of cells, this cause induce the host cell protein RecA, whose normal function is to induce expression of the cellular gene, which permit the cell to adapt to and survive in alternate environmental condition. RecA cleaves the CL repressor protein. Which protein determines the cycle? Now, lysogenic cycle, in case of lysogenic cycle, CL protein will be prominent, whereas in case of lytic cycle, crow protein, that is CRO protein, will be predominant. Lambda DNA replication. Initiation of replication of lambda origin require activation by the transcription start from PR. DNA replication is between O and P gene protein. The origin of lambda, that is origin of phage lambda with four binding site adjacent to AT-rich region. O protein binds to lambda origin, causes structural change in the origin. Now the P protein interact with the O protein. Lambda protein, O and P form a complex with the DNA B at lambda origin. A complex is inactive. This forms a spherical structure called ososomes. P protein, which is lambdas, bring DNA B to the origin of replication, make the duplex larger. AT-rich region become susceptible to nucleus attack. Recognize unpaired DNA, melt the DNA duplex. Shock protein, that is DNA K, DNA J, and group E gene, dissociate the origin of replication of lambda O and P DNA B complex to liberate the DNA B. DNA B initiate unwinding of the duplex. Primase start chain initiation and DNA polymerase 3 start elongation. Later, the circular multiply by theta form and continue for 5 to 15 minutes after infection. Rolling circle predominant after 15 minutes and produce a linear conketamer, which is a genomic linked end to end. Packaging require termination host factor provided by the host cell. So in this way, DNA can be replicated and DNA of the lambda phage can be replicated and it can be used for the vector. I mean, it can be used for recombinant DNA technology as a vector.
Thanks for watching my video. Please subscribe to my channel by clicking on subscription button. Subscription doesn't cost you any money. To get a notification, click on a bell icon. Do like and share this video with friends and family. If you have any kind of feedback, do share it on a comment box. Thank you.